health provision, security, job creation, drainage and water piping, housing and infrastructure are among the major issues that Kidero touched on, saying he will work hard to rid the city of the traffic jams by decongesting the central business district. On housing, he said he will address the plight of slum dwellers with a view to providing them with decent and affordable shelter.
Indeed, our list of challenges is long, including our current lack of capacity to manage solid waste, insufficient infrastructure development, poor public transport management system. To that we may also add our dilapidated health, social and educational facilities, our largely unserviced informal settlement accounting for 60% of the city residents, and lack of support system for small-scale businesses. As we are all aware, this list is not exhaustive, but we could have made it longer by mentioning, among others, the perennial problems of youth unemployment, in general, the overwhelming demand for service without commensurate capacity for the county to provide the same.
Kidero pointed out that his administration will strive to promote enterprises, address the rights of women, children, and people with disabilities. He also said he will streamline garbage collection in the city, which he said generates about 250,000 tons of garbage every day.
With a cooperation of development-conscious citizens in the areas of education, training, health sector, water and sanitation, environment, housing, urbanization, and the promotion of gender equity, youth empowerment, and the interests of vulnerable groups. Above all, the key component of Nairobi's leadership in the social pillar must be a sustained effort to champion Kenya's war against poverty.
His deputy Jonathan Mueke said he will work hard not to fail Kenyans who elected them. He said he knew there was a big road ahead, but they will strive to fulfill the promises they made to Kenyans. He also said they would automate services offered to citizens to make service delivery more efficient.
We will turn Nairobi into a smart city by employing modern technology to automate the entire county government operations, which will in turn enable us to devolve services to the constituency and eventually the ward level, thus bringing these services closer to the mwananchi. Kenya's new constitution is very clear about citizen participation in affairs of governance. We will therefore put systems in place, including utilizing Kenya's very vibrant social media to facilitate two-way communication between county government and its residents.
Prime Minister Raila Odinga congratulated the governor and urged him to look into the problem of housing as well as infrastructure. The Prime Minister also urged Kidero to unite with those he defeated and ensure residents of Nairobi enjoy life in a better Nairobi.
Kwa hivyo, tunaanza kazi sasa Nairobi. Kwanza nataka kutoa shukrani na pongezi kwa bwana Kidero kuchaguliwa kwa kura mingi zaidi kama gavana. Na bwana Mueke walifanya kampeni ya ajabu. Walipigana mpaka wakaangusha wale wengine. Sasa kazi inaanza. Na kazi sasa ni kushika wale ambaye uliwashinda na mwalete pamoja mfanye kazi pamoja. Manake sasa ni kutoa huduma kwa wananchi ambaye wanaishi Nairobi. Nairobi ni makao makuu sio tu ya Kenya, lakini ya Afrika Mashariki kwa jumla. Nairobi ndio mlango ya Kenya.
Other governors around the country were also sworn in, heralding the full implementation of the constitution. Eric Munene, GBS.